to dawn, round the clock. This is the boat with no place to go. Name, simply Test Barge, Evinrude Motors. Assignment, production run for the first engines off the 1960 line. It's baptism for each new model. An exhausting trial with emphasis on the big new Starflight II. Inside Evinrude, a final check on the 75 horsepower, 89 cubic inch motor borne through trial to meet the exacting standards of engineering. The Starflight's V4 design provides smoothness and perfect balance at all speeds. Aboard this custom-built dynamometer boat, the Starflight is ready for its initial run in a shakedown that's standard for each motor in the line. Two 300-horse caddies push this waterborne laboratory at almost 60 miles an hour. It's here that engine thrust is measured at any given speed. At the same time, deep inside a dynamometer cell, engineering records the horsepower of the new Starflight. Every model in the line receives a 1,000-hour test. At a monotonous beat, manual starts are clocked off until they exceed the 30,000 mark. More than 40,000 electric starts are made without breakdown. No component is overlooked. Even the starter key and its switch are tested. Each revolution, a flick of the switch, 178,000 turns and no fatigue. Under stress greater than that in any motor, flywheels withstand a burst test at 14,000 RPM. Every coil receives a sparking test against breakdown. A motor hood is about to be exploded. A mixture of acetylene and oxygen is used to create a blast impossible under normal conditions. Through tests like these, Evinrude developed a flame arrestor for its magnetos, putting safety on a par with performance. Even with this terrific force, the fiberglass hood refuses to shatter, remains intact. Dynamic balancing of the crankshaft assures power that's smooth and vibration-free. Evinrude metallurgists stand constant watch at a spectrometer. Each alloy in brass and steel is broken down and analyzed as the engineers determine that only the highest grade metals will go into each new motor. Crucial tests extend from Evinrude's deep freeze, where motors are started at zero temperatures, to the steaming hot room, 110 degrees, 100% humidity. 16 vital points of each motor shape up to a continuing temperature test. Heat variables in the water jacket and cylinder head are checked to a decimal. The accuracy of the potentiometer reading adds to Evinrude's success in thermostatic control. Sound waves, too, are part of testing. A motor cover on an airtight drum is hit by sound from an audio generator up to 20,000 cycles a second. The test duplicates a full range of engine noise, helps check against vibration of trim. The lower unit and shock absorbers of the Starflight take an unmerciful beating from the battering ram. In an attempt to break the back of each new motor, test drivers run an obstacle course at full throttle on the Milwaukee River. No trial is too great to meet the standards set at the drawing board. Control Center for Engineering is the office of Harry Ewald, where a mass of data is gathered, evaluated, and acted upon. Not the least important is up-to-the-minute information from Puget Sound, where in one of 100 field tests, a lone cruiser shakes down a new motor under a tight cloak of security. An outboard Marine DC-3 is dispatched to Evinrude's test station at Naples, Florida. From a laboratory on the Gulf of Mexico, each new model is checked in waters with the highest salt content in the nation. On test panels, a mosaic of enamels bakes in the sun as famed industrial designer Brooks Stevens confers with his associates on Evinrude styling. The 1960 motors combine function with flair, utility with a sweeping economy of line. In a never-ending quest for performance, engineering continues to launch its test craft. Simultaneously, sales director Bob Scott launches an aggressive marketing program for 1960. The agenda? A briefing on sales strategy. A preview of advertising in newspapers, magazines, radio, TV. A recap on publicity and sales promotion. Emphasis is placed on the Starflight's new Jetstream lower unit. There's no doubt about it. Evinrude has engineered a rugged motor, a powerful newcomer that's bound to leave the competition in its wake.